Okay, ready? Let me see. That I can see everyone. Hang on, yeah. Okay, who are in live now? Hi everyone, I'm back. So, ada yang boleh komen? just now, I was live on YouTube, okay, and then we couldn't comment in Facebook, so we actually moved to Facebook punya, you know, transmissions, okay, so that everyone can comment in Facebook lah, so I can see. I was feeling a bit lonely just now because I couldn't see everyone. So yeah, I was actually saying hi to everyone, and then we moved to Facebook, and I was about to talk about the first topic for the live sharing today, which is self-discovery, the need for self-discovery. So before I move into that, we got interrupted a little bit. So that's also a blessing in disguise. So everyone can actually watch us in Facebook sharing, yeah? So siapa-siapa yang di Facebook, whoever is in Facebook now, can you share this link so that we, you know, we can promote, we can share this topic, very interesting topic today. Okay, so yeah. So, bolehlah cakap, say hi everyone. Okay, hi in Facebook. So, loud and clear. Okay. Boleh juga say, you know, hi to me so I know who's there. Okay, so that I don't feel very lonely sharing. Okay. All right. So we have hello from everyone. Okay, mari, let's share the link. Okay, I just want to say hi to those on Facebook. Okay. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for bersabar. So let me just continue, yeah, for this session today. So actually I wanted to share about the need to do self-recovery, recovery pula, discovery. And I will be covering this topic, okay? What is self-discovery? What triggers self-discovery, and self-discovery and identity, are they the same, are they different, and who should be doing this, and why is it important to do self-discovery, and what is out there to help with self-discovery. Okay, untuk benefits local, okay, saya translate lagi apa cerita saya live hari ini. So basically, saya mau cerita pasal kenali diri kita lebih mendalam. Okay, kalau kau Google self-discovery, dia punya translations tu dia cakap penemuan diri. which is so awkward. So basically it is kenali diri kita dengan lebih mendalam, itu yang what is self discovery all about lah. Jadi saya akan cuba cerita pasal apa itu self discovery, apa itu kenali diri kita dengan lebih mendalam, and then apa itu apa yang trigger kita orang punya hati kita untuk mencari kebenaran diri, siapa diri kita. And then saya mau also cover topik identity dan pengenalan diri, adakah dia sama atau tak sama begitu. And then kenapa, siapa yang perlu self discovery, siapa yang perlu buat ni kenal dengan lebih mendalam, dan kenapa dia penting, kenapa dia penting. Okay, and then adakah teknik di luar situ untuk membantu kita untuk kenali diri kita lah, ada teknik kan di luar situ. Yeah, so itu actually topik yang saya mau cover. Alright, so marilah join saya without further ado. Let me just you know, earlier tadi saya actually begin with a statement introductions like this. There are two injustices in this world. The first injustice is to treat people, animals and plants badly. And the second injustice actually to ignore who you are in this life. Erti kata lain, injustice macam ketidakadilan. Saya ada dua perasaan ketidakadilan dalam dunia ni. Satu, number one ialah kita melayan sesama manusia, binatang dan juga alam sekitar lah, okay? Badly, jahat lah. Saya pun tidak tahu macam mana sudah mau translate badly in bahasa. Kita tidak baiklah, kita tidak melayan dia. Di satu lagi ketidakadilan yang saya rasa ialah kita tidak mau ambil tahu pasal diri kita. Kita tidak mau kenali diri kita sendiri dengan lebih mendalam dalam dunia ini. Kita, ya, itu saya punya injustice. Dia macam trigger deep thinking. Dia trigger kita orang punya pemikiran lah. It triggers us. Okay, so discover yourself in this life. Carilah, kenalilah diri kita dengan lebih mendalam dalam dunia ini. Okay. So what is actually self-discovery? Apa sebenarnya ni kenali diri kita dengan lebih mendalam? In the dictionary, you know, if you go and Google about self-discovery, it is actually like they define self-discovery like self-reflections, self-contemplation, self-questioning, your self-searching, self-examinations, and self-scrutiny, and many more. Yeah. So mengenali diri kita, kita kalau macam di kamus, itulah translations dia, penemuan diri. Another one is kau sentiasa bertanya apa kelebihan, mencarilah kelebihan dan kekurangan diri kita. Kau buat refleksi sendiri. So itu adalah salah satu self discovery lah kalau dalam macam kamus-kamus kita ni, kan? Okay, in a nutshell, actually it is about finding out, understanding of who you are at the core, yeah? Mencari siapa diri kita sebenarnya. Okay, so yeah, say hello to everyone. Kita mari kita mengenali diri. Mari kita, ya. kenali follow these topics closely because this is very interesting. I want to share the view on this. All right, so which is good. Okay, so kenali diri kita. This self-discovery is actually to find out and understand who you really are and what you lack in this life, what are your strengths in this life, comprehending weaknesses and strengths, ataupun realize your strengths, your weakness, and then what can those do for you, for your family and for your career, for the wider community, and for the whole world. What motivates you? Yeah. And then what is your patience? What makes your relationship better with people around you? And then what do you behave in certain ways? Why others can do what you do and why others cannot? Yeah. And very interesting. Interesting, right? So basically kalau saya tukar bahasa dia, kita self-discovery ni kita cari apa kita punya kelemahan, apa kita punya kelebihan, and then kita boleh understand, kita boleh faham kita orang punya kelemahan dan kelebihan, and dengan understanding, dengan pemahaman kita punya kelebihan dan kelemahan ni, kita berfikir apa dia boleh tolong bantu kita dalam hidup ini, hidup kita, apa dia boleh bantu untuk keluarga kita, untuk community kita, dan for the whole world, untuk dunia, ya. Dan dengan self discovery ini, kau pun boleh tahu apa yang boleh buat kau motivasi, boleh memberikan kau motivasi. Apa yang kau suka, and then macam mana, apa yang boleh membuatkan kita orang punya persahabatan, kita punya komunikasi dengan orang lain lebih baik, kan, lebih baik. Dan kau boleh tahu why do you behave in certain ways. So basically kau punya perangai, kenapa kau berperangai seperti itu kalau kau do your self-discovery. Dan mungkin kau bertanya juga, kenapa apa yang kau buat ni orang lain tak dapat buat? Kenapa begitu? Sangat menarik, bukan? Menarik, kan? Interesting, okay? So, basically this self-discovery, it helps you to get rid of unimportant matters in your life. It helps you to find the core values, okay, and living in alignment with your inner truths. And this may lead you to know what is your purpose in this life. So basically, kalau kita tukar in other words, in bahasa, dengan mengenali diri kita, kita actually boleh, kita cakap buang tabiat yang tidak bagus, yang tidak penting dalam hidup kita, and then kita boleh mencari kita punya value. Itu mau Google sikit, apa value dalam bahasa bahasa ni, mungkin macam nilai-nilai dalam hidup kita lah, kan? Okay, and then kita boleh hidup dengan lebih align lah, lebih lurus, ikut kita orang punya value. Macam boleh tak faham, ya? Ikut kita punya inner truth, macam apa sebenarnya kita suka dan tak suka, something like that lah, okay? And then with this, moga-moga dia dapat membuka jalan untuk kita lihat apa tujuan dalam hidup kita, ya? Apa tujuan dia yang lebih besar daripada just go to work, go home, jaga family, begitu saja. Mesti ada something, ya. Yeah? So this self discovery kan is it can go deeper in your life. It is actually a lifelong journey of explorations through our inner self, and the golden value of doing this is you get to understand yourself better every time, and you grow wiser as you grow older. Okay, so dengan mengenali kita lebih dalam ini, okay, dia adalah satu perjalanan hidup lah. Perjalanan hidup kita sentiasa mencari kebenaran diri kita. Siapa diri kita? Kan kebenaran. Siapa diri kita dari dalam lah. Dan kita boleh memahami siapa diri kita, dan kita boleh kita boleh macam bangun, ya. Kita boleh sentiasa memajukan diri kita dan menjadi bijak pandai. macam as we grow older, kita umur semakin meningkat, kita pun ada orang cakap wisdom, itu lagi. Sorry bahasa yang sangat kurang vocabulary ini ya, but kamu pun fahamlah, ada wisdom. Kita sudah, we grow old, we are wiser, we have wisdom. Okay? And that moves me into this next points, yeah? My next point is, apa or what triggers self-discovery? This is going to be very interesting. You are working right now, yeah, and life happens. Suddenly you are thinking, why are you doing this job? Why is it that it doesn't feel right anymore? You are feeling stuck, exhausted, feel tired, and worse, you feel useless. You feel like you are not appreciated. You are not recognized for the efforts that you put in, no matter how hard you try. You feel that way. You are not appreciated. You know, you are not recognized. You are struggling, but you kept going. Okay? You kept going because of one simple, because of the luxury of your job is paying you, or the comfortable pace that you feel. Yeah, you cannot just give up on the next paycheck, and you feel so limited, you are unhappy, you are upset, and makes all kinds of excuses to make your conscious self feel better. Sound familiar, right? It's, I think, relatable to many of you. Only you know that. Sekejap yuk, kita minum dulu. Santai kita, santai ya. So I just want to see online. Thank you for watching again, ya. So saya sudah sampai topik what triggers self-discovery. So basically, what I'm trying to say tadi itu, what triggers the self-discovery, apa yang buat kita tiba-tiba merasa macam kita mesti mau kenal diri kita, macam ada refleksi dia di situ, kan? So imagine this. Kamu sedang bekerja, and then life happens, ya, kehidupan. Mungkin ada something, kejadian dalam hidup kamu orang. Tiba-tiba kau terfikir, kenapa kau buat kerja ini, ya? Kenapa dia macam rasa tidak sesuai sudah dengan kamu? And then you feel stuck, kau rasa macam terhad, kau rasa orang cakap, depressed lah, frustrated orang cakap, penat, dan paling tidak bagus perasaan bukan rasa macam tidak berguna. Okay, so that is what happened. And then kau rasa juga macam kau tidak dihargai, kau tidak dikenali, dihargai, dikenali, kau punya kerja yang kau pernah penat buat tu pun macam tidak kena orang cakap tidak direcognize, tidak di apa orang cakap apa, appreciate lah kan, tidak kena tengok. So kau struggle lah, kau macam berusaha, and then kau tetap juga move on, kau tetap juga kerja juga walaupun sudah terasa begitu. Kenapa? Sebab you need the money, kan? Kau mau kena, kau mau duit dia, kau mau keselesaan hidup itu, kau masih mau keselesaan hidup daripada gaji kamu, kan? And then, as you struggle, bila kamu sudah rasa masih juga mencuba, then kamu pun rasa macam kamu bagi banyak alasan, all kinds of excuses, alasan untuk diri kamu untuk bertahan, supaya kamu rasa macam selesa, rasa selesa lah, kan? Supaya kamu okay, apa nama, selagi boleh buat, buatlah, kasih selesa lah, kasih positif, apa semua lah, itu yang kamu orang mau, this one, itu yang kamu orang mau bagi tahu diri kamu, kan? So sound familiar tak? Ada yang merasa begitu? Mungkin hari ini ataupun mungkin hari yang you know, ada satu masa pula, kan? Excuse kejap, ah. Okay. So, baiklah. Normally, what triggers a self-discovery ini kan is actually a burnout case. Okay? And this can happen. And then only the self-discovery takes place. So, yeah, apa yang buat kita tiba-tiba tersedar lah, tersedar dari semua ni, semua kepenatan kita, exhaustion, semua ni kan, bila kita orang cakap breakdown, nervous breakdown, bila kita macam rasa apa nama, really depressed lah, depressed, terus tidak boleh buat apa-apa. So that is the time, probably the time that you you know, you sedar, you know. So in a nutshell, self-discovery ni kan starts when you encounter that limitations. Okay, limitations. But well, only if you take actions to go and understand about who you are lah. Kalau dia punya trigger ni, you already know. Tapi only if you take actions lah to go and do something about it. Unfortunately, okay, many are still justifying or negotiating with themselves, telling themselves that it's just a fate, F-A-T-E, okay, living the life as fate spells it out. It is what it is, and with fate, there is no choice for you to live the way you are, okay, so. Yeah, unfortunately, malang sekali. Ini self-discovery ini tidak ramai yang peduli sangat. So, bila diorang dalam keadaan macam tidak selesa sudah, kurang selesa, macam memang kena bully lah, rasa dia macam kena bully di mana-mana kita berada. And then, diorang akan bagi tahu diri diorang, negotiate, berbincang dengan diri diorang, kasih diorang rasa very selesa, bilang, okay, sudah takdir. Takdir, fate is takdir, kan? Sudah takdir, biar sajalah. biar sajalah hidup begini. Takdir sudah turun. Nah, kita teruskan saja, serahkan saja kepada takdir. Semua ini. So basically, dia macam tidak bagi chance lah. Huh? Tidak bagi jalan keluar sudah. Sebab dia orang sudah cakap itu takdir. Interesting, right? Okay. So, that's it. Sebelum saya masuk masuk ke topik seterusnya, saya rasa informasi kita sudah banyak. We already covered two topics. One is the what exactly is self-discovery, and then the other one is what triggers the self-discovery. Okay. Jangan serius juga. Okay. So before I proceed to the next topic, kan? Let's break and let's have a break and we have fun. Mari kita main guessing game. Let's play some guessing game. Okay, so stay tuned. Saya kasih serahkan mic ini dulu kepada kita punya game coordinator, Miss Rebecca. Sila ambil ahli. Kita main kita orang punya guessing game.
Hello, hello everyone. Thank you, Tres. Thank you very much. Tres from Miri Jawa. Hello, everyone. Thank you. Stay tuned. Still stay tuned with us. Okay. Let me introduce myself first before we move on to the guessing game. Okay. My name is Rebecca Majantin from Borneo, Sabah, Kota Kinabalu. So thank you for joining me for our live streaming first. 2020, yeah. Okay, before we start, let me tell the prices. You can see my background here. There's a flower and two EMF speaker. Actually, the benefit of EMF is to help to harmonize the energy or the aggressive frequency. So you can put it on your smartphone, laptop, or computer. So, okay, before that, anyone can hear me clearly? Yeah, because I didn't see the Facebook chat. Okay, everyone can hear me? Very clear? Boleh dengar? Can say anything? Boleh dengar, kak? Ataupun suara macam di gua, kak? Okay, let me move on to the guessing game lah ya. Because okay, before that, the EMF speaker. Okay, the EMF speaker benefit is to harmonize the energy or the frequency, aggressive frequency. Yeah. So the prices for the winning for the guessing game. There's the flowers and two EMF, yeah, two EMF speaker for the winner. So each winner can get two speaker and the flower. And the shipping, for the shipping not included, yeah. Okay. Tanpa buang masalah, so let us start our first guessing game today. Okay, the word. Guessing game. What is earlier Tracy mentioned about is a self-discovery is all about data, who you are. Okay, one word. Self-discovery is all about face who you are. Okay, you can start now. One word only. Okay. Come on, everyone. Try to guess what is the one word that Miss Tracy mentioned about earlier. Can everyone give the answer or guess the answer? So the prices you can see at my background, yeah? Flowers and two stickers. You can give this gift to your lovely one since the Valentine's Day is around the corner. So maybe you can get a free flower from us and two stickers you can put on your smartphone, laptop, or computer, anything. Or you can give both of it to your loved one, parents. Okay, anyone, one word on me that Tracy mentioned about this earlier. Self-discovery is all about space, one word, who you are. Anyone, can you think again? Just give one word. And thank you for stay tuned with us. Hello, everyone. Hello from Singapore. Hello from Phnom Penh. Hello from everywhere in KK, Kota Kinabalu, and below the wind. Two speaker and one flower. So the postage not including, yeah. So if you are the winner, you can contact us. One word. Anyone, one word, satu-satu saja. Kita yang rajin, can check duluan kali guys, atau beli duluan juga. Come on, one word only, you can have three flower and two EMF speaker, you can put on your handphone or laptop. Okay, welcome to our guessing game, hello, we are... Welcome to our guessing game. We are in the guessing game now. Come on. Anyone can give the answer. One word only, okay? You can get flower to your loved one, parent, you can give, or sibling, anyone. Keep guessing, my friend. Anyone? Oh, is there any winner for? Is the word just mentioned earlier, one word only, one word. The self-discovery is all about space, who you are, okay? Any winner? I think so, there's the winner. Anyone, one word. Okay. Can I know who is the winner? Is there any winner? Any winner? Okay, the benefit of EMF is to harmonize the frequency of any electronic, gadget, can see. Okay, let me see. Oh, okay. One winner for this year. Okay, the winner is Cairo Azra Baba. Congratulations, Cairo. You can contact us, for your prizes. Congratulations, you won one flower for your lovely one or your parents or anyone you want to do it, and you got two MS speaker, yeah. Okay, congratulations, Cairo. So we are going to move on, or going back to Tracy now. Hope Tracy. Okay, hello, Tress. We got the winner to the Tress.
Yay, congratulations. To the winner. And yeah, thank you for the fun games, Rep. Thank you for the fun games and the generous gifts from AI Wellness.
Okay.
So congratulations to Khairul. Thank you for joining. Stay tuned, you know. Ada lagi next game, okay? Ada lagi next game tuh. Kita jemput lagi si Rebecca. All right. Okay. All right. So thank you. And now let's continue with the next topic. I have self-discovery. The next topic is self-discovery and self-identity. Are they the same or different? What is our self-identity? Let me start with self-identity. Okay. I begin with that, and then this is self-identity. Ini kan is to identify and you define yourself. Your self-identity is actually a combination of your personal traits, abilities, physical attributes, your interests, your hobbies, and or your social roles from your personal identity that you specifically selected to identify yourself. Your self-identity is who you become over the years with or without realizing it. maybe susah sangat mau faham kan? Dia berlilit-lilit di situ. So kita punya self-identity. I think dia direct translations juga kan? Self-identity ini. Sebenarnya dia ialah identity yang kita become, kita jadi tanpa kita tahu. Macam kita sedar. Kita sedar atau tidak sedar. Dia jadi kita punya identity. Based on kita punya hobi, macam apa yang kita suka buat, based on kita punya interest lah, interest, kita punya personality. So, dia jadi identity kita tanpa kita sadari. Atau kita sadar juga. Okay? So, often, this self-identity is found through self-discovery. Yeah? Sebenarnya, kita punya identity ini often lah, macam selalunya kita juga dapat jumpa identiti kita melalui proses kenali diri kita lebih mendalam. So that's what it means. Okay, let me share a story about myself. A little story about myself. Yeah. So when I was working in a corporate world, I was someone who get along with so many colleagues. I like to avoid confrontations if possible. I don't like confrontations. I was someone who loves to think through a lot of details and does not like it if the task gets too complex and without a clear structure. And I realized these traits of mine, and on the side, I also noticed I like something. I like to coach. I like to teach. I like to guide my clients so that they can quickly get the understanding of what details they wanted from me and help them to assess if it is really what they needed to help them, if it's really relevant for their job. It saves them time, and that's what that's when I start to identify myself as a go-to person, yeah, for details of understanding of the task that I'm doing. Okay, so yeah, saya cerita pasal diri saya lah. Sebab masa saya kerja di multinational company dulu, saya ni jenis yang orang cakap friendly, ramah jugalah. Bolehlah berkawan. Okay, saya tidak suka gaduh. Saya tak suka konfrontasi itu. Kalau boleh, saya mau avoid dia. Saya mau elak dia semua. Jadi, tidak maulah ada gaduh-gaduh ni. Kalau boleh, mau understand mau understand semua kerja-kerja tu dengan cara aman damai. Okay, so and also saya jenis orang yang details juga. Perinci juga, terperinci kalau mau buat kerja tu. Saya tidak suka juga kalau kerja tu macam terlalu susah mau faham. Tidak ada structure tu. Saya sangat tidak boleh terima tu barang. Okay, Tapi saya coba juga lah. So saya notice lah saya punya perangai begitu. And then saya juga notice satu perangai saya suka macam mengajar. Coach orang cakap mengajar, kasih guide sama orang baru dengan saya punya customer, saya punya client, saya guide dia orang macam kalau dia orang mau datang, mau minta data dari saya begitu kan. Saya akan guide dia orang. Saya tengok apa dia orang bekerja and then saya akan explain lah saya punya numbers kah saya punya kerja ni adakah dia relevan untuk dia orang tu. So in a way I help them, saya tolong dia orang jimat masa dia orang, tak payah dia orang analyze analisis kerja-kerja saya tu to tengok whether dia ngam untuk kerja dia orang ke tidak. Saya sudah buat itu untuk diorang. Saya akan guide diorang. Saya akan tanya diorang specific questions related, and then diorang akan buat decisions. Diorang nak data saya atau tidak. So kerja diorang senanglah. Jadi senanglah kerja diorang kan. So that is me. So saya pun tahu sedar after a while. Lepas tu saya jadi macam orang yang go-to person, macam kalau dia orang minta details, minta pemahaman apa semua, minta data, dia orang datang pada saya, begitu. So saya akan sedia membantu dia orang lah. So that's me. So this identity as a go-to person, okay, for me comes from a series of self-discoveries throughout the years of my working life. Yeah, series. Satu-satu macam sebab experience saya bekerja tu kan dia bagi saya kesedaran lah, macam saya kenal diri saya dan saya tahu apa saya punya strength. So through my working life lah baru saya sedar. Okay, so I know in this life I have more to offer. I have more in me that I can tap and I can help more people around me and in the world. It just excites me, to discover this. It excites me to just think about what else do I have in me? What else do I have in me? You know, and it should also excite any one of you out there, you know, to do your self-discovery and be relevant to whatever you are doing today. Okay, so erti kata lain begini, saya jadi excited lah, mau kenali diri saya sendiri dengan lebih mendalam. Sebab dengan mengenali diri lebih mendalam, saya tahu apa saya punya kelebihan, kelemahan. Saya tahu semua tu dan saya boleh macam improve, okay? Boleh membantu orang lain, begitu, membantu orang lain. So saya excited untuk mengambil tahu tentang diri saya. So it should be for you as well. Untuk kamu di luar sana, kamu pun perlu rasa excited, you know. Get to know yourself more. When you know, kalau kamu tahu diri kamu sendiri, then it is so good. You feel so good. Kau rasa sangat senang hati dan rasa macam boleh bantu orang and rasa gembira lah, you know, self, kan? So if you are still trying to identify yourself, go through this self-discovery. Yeah, the process of self-discovery. Kamu harus macam kalau belum lagi kamu discover, kamu orang punya kelebihan, kelemahan, begitu. Go through this self-discovery. Okay, so that brings me to my next point, which is who should be doing this self-discovery. Siapa yang perlukan self-discovery? Let me tell you. Or maybe What if I tell you kan, as early as your childhood, you can discover your strengths and your weaknesses and what you may be good at. Apa? Macam mana mau translate dia? As early as your childhood, kamu macam kamu dari apa nama budak-budak lagi. Walaupun kamu masih budak, kamu masih kanak-kanak, bukan budak, kanak-kanak. Kamu actually boleh tahu apa kelemahan, apa kelebihan yang kamu ada. So, apa yang kamu boleh buat dengan lebih baik sekali? Yeah, yes, early self-discovery, and it's possible, you know. Self-discovery is for everyone of all ages. Okay, self-discovery ini untuk semua lapisan umur. Betul kan tuh? Lapisan umur, lapisan masyarakat. Dari kau kecil sampai kau dewasa. Why? Why? How? How so? Macam mana pula? Dari kecil tuh kan? Parents lah. Okay? Parents discover children's inbuilt ability earlier and they are able to provide the proper and better guidance of what beliefs and values and directions each child should focus earlier. So, maksud dia dari kecil kita boleh tahu sudah kan melalui ibu bapa, melalui kalau kamu ada anak, melalui kamu sendiri. Kamu lebih cepat mengenali apa kelebihan anak kamu, apa kekurangan dia, and then kamu boleh macam guide dia dengan lebih teratur lebih kepada dia mana yang dia orang perlu lah lebih fokus dengan lebih awal lagi kamu fokus apa yang kamu perlu guide anak-anak kamu. And siapa lagi yang perlu this self-discovery? Okay, who else? Companies will be able to save their time by hiring suitable employees when they know the strengths, okay, and capabilities. And capacity of the individual earlier through the process of personality test and also personal discovery. Okay, so yeah, company akan save masa dia orang, macam jimat masa dia orang. Kalau dia orang mengenali orang sebelum dia orang mau hire, macam mau recruit dia punya pekerja, dia orang boleh suruh orang cakap tu yang mau apply kerja tu lah bakal employees dia orang tu boleh duduk dan buat itu soalan tanda tanya soalan quiz tentang diri dia orang lah. Okay, so dia orang akan lebih tahu adakah mereka yang bakal kena hire tu, kena jadi pekerja tu sesuai untuk diorang atau tidak. Diorang jimat masa. Diorang boleh tahu dari situ. Kalau diorang ada self-discovery process lah, kan? And then the other thing is that communications and relationships, it can be better and more harmonious, okay? When one knows what the others are like, okay? One can be more compassionate and be less aggressive as well, okay? So dengan adanya kita orang punya pemahaman tentang diri kita, kita boleh perbaiki kita orang punya komunikasi atau relationship, hubungan sahabat, hubungan suami istri atau hubungan dengan keluarga-keluarga lain. Okay? Sebab kita kenal siapa diri kita and then kita boleh kurangkan tabiat yang tidak bagus lah. Kan, tabiat yang tidak bagus supaya kita kekal berkawan kan dengan aman damai. So the next points that I want to cover is why is it important to do self discovery. Okay, it's getting boring sudah kan. So saya stop sini dulu. Saya mau buat games lagi. So we have another round of fun. Okay, before I go into why is it important to do self discovery. Boleh tak? Mana sudah si Rebecca tuh? Let's pass this button mic back to Rebecca. Good luck, guys.
Thanks, welcome back. Oke, mangkali suara saya ini macam di gua, tapi saya coba sedaya upaya kasih tarang lah suara saya, oke? Walaupun macam di gua. Oke, now we move on to second guessing game ya. So question dia begini ya. So before that, dia punya prices. For the prices, can see at my background here, one bouquet of Valentine and two pieces of EMF atau sticker EMF. So it benefit ya atau kegunaan dia adalah untuk for protect aggressive frequency atau aggressive aggressive frequency lah. So energy, more cakap energy lah. So kegunaannya, you can put at the back, jadinya smartphone ataupun ya kamu boleh letak di laptop or computer or anything, or you can put on your apa plug or switch anything switch lah, just put on at the back macam ni ya. So you can put on ya mind switch pun boleh, so supaya the energy or the aggressive frequency dia control, so it goes smooth, so dia tidak directly to your body, dia tidak attack to your body lah, so it's smooth energy ya. So you can get two of it and one big flower ya, for those yang for the winner lah ya. So you can give to your lovely one, so parents lah, so because Valentine is on the corner, sudah kan sudah, so this is a very good opportunity to win itu hadiah, so free saja kan, so tinggal harganya pun mau tidak kan, so cara dia senang saja, getting one word then you can get all these things, so not including shipping ya, so kalau apa you can collect from to our office juga lah, so our office is Plaza Tanjung Aru ya, Plaza Tanjung Aru. Okay, our dating game question, okay. So tadi mungkin kamu concentrate what Tracy talk about kan. So now the question is, easy saja lah. According to the Tracy, parents would benefit from self-discovery of their children. So what are those benefits? And name two benefits to parents that Tracy mentioned about just now. Okay, two benefit, yeah, two word letter. Okay, so you can start now. Okay, I repeat the question. Okay, according to the Tracy lah, apa yang dia cakap tadi kan? Okay, parents would benefit from self-discovery of their children. What are those benefits? And name two benefits to parents. Okay. Benefit, so it's mean apa Melayu ah, apa kebaikan, ya yeah, kebaikan, benefit, two benefit, kebaikan to parents. So I hope ngambil itu translation. So come on guys, bagi jawapan. So hadiah dia ada ini di belakang saya, you can see it, and the prizes, so two sticker juga. Okay, thank you to those who speaking with us. Thank you. Please share. Easy to get the prizes saja. Guess the word. Apakah kebaikan? Ibu bapa kalau buat discovery anak mereka. Tidak cukup sekolah Benny. Gagal BM ya sekarang. Oh, pakai translator ini. So itulah apa kebaikan ya kepada ibu bapa kalau buat self discovery untuk anaknya. Nanti Tracy rewind lah kan apa yang dicap. So okay, come on guys, itu apa two words apa kebaikan parents, what apa baru kita translate dari words ini kan baru ke apa jadinya. Gagal bagi MC. Ini pun agak gagal. So, jadi passion aja lah. Cari saja lah, membaca lah. Okay. The other question is, parents would benefit from self-discovery of their children. The question again, what are those benefits? And name two benefits to parents. Kebaikan untuk parents lah. Kebaikan untuk parents lah. Apabila dia discovery apa diri itu parents discovery tentang diri orang ini. Apa kebaikan untuk anak-anak mereka? Oh, harap betul. So please, come on guys. Second team punya apa hadiah sama juga macam just now. Satu buket flowers and two EMF. Kebaikan dia sangat bagus tau ini speaker. Speaker dia sangat baik. Okay. Besar dia beginilah. Can put on your apa? Can put on your smartphone, gadgets. Because all gadgets sekarang, let's say myself, pegang-pegang itu phone, ayah, you know, the apa, numb, pandai numb. So the, apalagi kalau banyak WhatsApp, all the WhatsApp go inside, nah, kau punya hand also rasa feel macam numb. And then you cannot, macam pindah tangan lah lagi. And then, kalau sebelah dia, so, if you put on this thing at the back of your smartphone, smartphone, so it will reduce itu frequency to the apa gadget lah. So it mean soft lah. So dia tidak berapa efek to your semua tangan lah. So it may be for apalah reduce the apalah frequency and feel all your body. So it mean it's not good for your organ kan. Kalau all the things electronic masuk ke all your body. Yeah, of course, tidak bagus. So kalau boleh, stay away all the electronic kan. But what to do in our modern ni semua, everything is electronic. So we have to use it. So now pun mau pakai electronic, I have to check. Distance jauh pun have to use. So ada kebaikan dan keburukan. But we got solution. AI sediakan ini untuk all those. So lucky lah who the winner to get this too. You can give your loved one and for yourself and flower too. So very good. So any winner? Come on, everyone. Come on, everyone. Guessing game. Welcome to our guessing game. For those who are just tuned with us, I hope my question study question pun very clear. I repeat the question again, yeah. So what are those benefits and name it two benefits to the parents, yeah? Parents would benefit from self-discovery of their children. So what are those two benefits? Dua saja. So peta-peta saja, tulis. Tap saja, anything words come out from your mind, just kasihlah apa dia. Nanti saya stress menunggu ya. Okay, for those yang winning or win prize tadi, siapa kalau for our apa, don't forget to contact us lah. So our number pun ada tertera, or go to our Facebook and you can see every information about it. Then please for the prices, yeah. Then you can arrange for the transportation or grab anything. Mana mana kamu antar the flower with the EMS, yeah. Or you can come and to our office to collect it yourself. Okay. So anyone winning the prize, or ataupun kamu winning the prize and give to me. Okay. The question is, parents would benefit from self-discovery of their children. What are those benefits and name two benefits to the parents? So Tracy ada mention it about just now. So saya juga tidak ingat. Tentu saja kamu tidak ingat. So tak saja apa the words. So the words or the answer. Mau bagi tips kah? Saya pernah bagi tips lah. Gagal bagian. So, macam mana mau bagi tips kan? So, anyone, go ahead. Just try. Come on, cahyo, everyone. Yeah, you get two EMF and one bouquet of flower. Bouquet, one bouquet flower and two EMF. Kebaikan dia sangat bagus lah. It's so banyak kebaikannya. Actually, banyak nih produk kami. Actually, AEI Wellness banyak produk. So this one is one of them lah. So you just go our apa Facebook, then you can click the anything. You want to know more about kami punya produk pun boleh. So anything, semua bagus-bagus. So tidak rugi untuk dapat. Okay. So question dia tadi lah kan. Saya punya, okay lah bagi hin-hin lah. Saya pun tidak tahu betul pasti cakap ni. Tapi kamu cubalah pikirkan sesuatu. Pikirkan kalau kau tahu kelebihan atau kekurangan anak-anak. Apa kau mau buat? Okay. Ah, itu cukup bagus ya tipsnya. Apa kebaikan? Apa itu parents dapat sekiranya apa kebaikan? Apa yang parents itu dapat? Apa kebaikan yang parents dapat sekiranya dia apa from dia punya self discovery? Parents benefit from self discovery. Apa benefit from self discovery from parents to their children, kekurangan anak-anak, kebaikan, apa kebaikan kamu dapat? Macam, hello, come on, kata-kata lah, only a dua, you can put, okay, kita cek dulu lah, kita cek di Facebook, okay, mana answer dia? Banyak kalau kamu kata-katakan di sini is the ini apa Tracy mention. Okay, saya tengok di Facebook sekarang pun. Memang betul lah semua kamu cakap ni apa benefit parents semua berkait mengait juga, tapi yang kami mau bagi hadiah ni kan yang Tracy cakap tadi lah yang ada ngam the words ngam. So memang betul juga lah kamu cakap ni semua student dah happy student. Okay, kalau saya pun memang banyak lah tidak dapat kira tu cuma apa yang si Tracy mention tadi yang paling betul lah kan. Kalau sebab kita mau cari pemenang bahkan satu saja, one pemenang one can get this one. Okay, so dia punya apa, okay let me see ya, let me see again ah. Okay, let me see. Okay, come on. Kalau boleh kamu repeat balik ya. Repeat kamu punya apa yang jawaban. Apa yang maybe kesana sudah tidak nampak. Okay, sebab ketika sudah balik. Saya rasa kamu dengar bahkan. Okay, let me see. Oh, okay. Any winner? Okay, I can see from Facebook. Kalau saya punya apa ni tidak nampak, saya punya zoom saja ni. Okay, ada did you mention apa semua? Okay, mesti yang betul. I mean the correctly lah apa yang Tracy mention dia. Okay. So tip dia pun ada sudah saya kasih tahu. Okay. Okay, anyone? So, let our admin kasih apa? Click. Okay, sudah congratulations. Then I can nampak sudah. So, dapat sudah. Okay, maybe sebenarnya kalian ini lambat betul. So, I cannot see. Okay, dapat sudah. Congratulations. Maybe admin sudah click on like kamu punya jawaban. Okay. Okay, dia punya the winner is Nusuhada Saida. Okay, am I correct the word? Kamu punya nama, harap ngam lah itu, pronunciation kamu punya nama. Okay, Congratulations, yeah, Nur Shahada. Thank you, congratulations, thank you. And thank you, Khairu and Nur Shahada for the, apa, to menang kami punya hadiah. So, contact us, yeah. I mean, try to, apa, kami, yeah. So, you can get the flowers. Okay, or you just come over and we arrange the, apa, yeah. Penghantaran. Okay, Tres, thank you. Tres, welcome back. On to you.
Hi, thanks. Okay, thank you again, Miss Rebecca. Yeah, actually, semua jawapan tadi kind of very, very near. So I select something that's almost in the same context lah. Okay? Yeah, almost in the same context. So congratulations yang yang menjawab, yang dapat menjawab tadi. So Nur Syuhada, congratulations, yeah. So yes, so this topic is getting interesting. Okay, so I already cover about four topics tadi kan. So yang last two tadi I cover the self discovery and self identity, and who should do the self discovery. That's when I talk about parents can help their children when they know dia orang punya ability, they can actually help them. Give them the opportunities, guide them lah to the right, kan? Guide them in the to focus on what they have earlier. Okay, so congratulations, very very new semua. So I only select those yang ngam lah, have the context. Alright, so cuba lagi. We still have peluang, tapi not today. Today saya have to. Cover two more topics, two more contents before we actually end this live. So this one is why is it important to do the self-discovery? Okay, so you out there, you want to know your potential and whatever that you have in you, you should do this self-discovery process in you. Okay, because this self-discovery, they help us to identify our abilities and also how we can leverage and develop kita punya abilities too, our abilities. And then when people know, biasanya when people know what they are passionate about, and it is actually easier to grasp the concept and then to accept them. So. Yes, if you want to know, this self-discovery ni kan kita boleh kenali kita punya kekuatan dan kelemahan diri lah kan, and then kita boleh macam ambil peluang untuk memperbaiki diri kita lagi. Okay, bila kita tahu sendiri apa yang kita boleh buat, apa kita punya kelebihan atau kelemahan, kita ambil tindakan, kita ambil peluang, lebih senang untuk kita mau cari jalan lah, macam mana kita mau memperbaiki dia. So that is the importance, kepentingan self-discovery. Okay. So when we find the paths that we want and we pursue that paths, then it makes us feel happy. Kan? Kalau kita dapat kenali diri kita, kita tahu apa yang kita suka dan kita ikut jalan itu kan, jalan itu, dan kita akan rasa lebih tenang, lebih gembira lah. Betul tak? Okay, so that's just a short one. And then now I'm coming into the what is out there to help with this self-discovery. Apa yang ada di luar sana yang actually boleh bantu kita untuk kita assess, kita tengok apa kita punya diri, kelebihan dan kelemahan diri. Ada proses, ada macam teknik ke begitulah kan. There are so many modalities out there to do this self-discovery. It's from the intellectual questions to the coaching, to do meditations and personality tests, the Bazi reading, zodiacs, or Chinese astrology readings, crystals, you know, using crystals, and then many more. Yeah, dia ada kita ada banyak teknik di luar situ untuk belajar mengenali tentang diri kita. Kita boleh jawab soalan, kita boleh dapat coach, one-to-one coach, kita boleh buat meditasi, you know, meditations, to know reflections kita punya diri, and then kita boleh buat macam personality test. Ada kan selalu tu di internet kita buat personality test kita, and then ada reading, Bazzi reading ni. Okay, so ini bagi mereka yang apalah, Bazzi is some kind of astrology punya lah, macam ialah termasuk zodiac dan Chinese punya astrology reading. Okay, and then kita boleh ada yang sekarang guna crystals untuk mengenali diri orang, untuk help them, okay, untuk kenal. These are all good processes. It guides, it provides us with the guides and a structure to help us to initiate our inner thoughts. Okay, semua teknik ini yang di luar situ, dia adalah sangat bagus. Dia bagi kita jalan, buka jalan untuk kita. Dia bagi kita structure untuk kita macam kasih start kita orang punya macam pengetahuan tentang diri kita dengan lebih mendalam tu. Okay, and the 1 million questions or 1 million statement here questions. I don't know whether you have ever heard of this self-discovery called Loshu Astrology. Soalan cepu emas gak orang bilang tu kan? So saya tak tahu kamu di luar sana pernah dengar tak satu teknik yang dipanggil Loshu Astrology. Okay, so apa nih? Yeah, self-discovery using Loshu Astrology. It is an ancient way of self-discovery technique. It is founded and improved and used more than 4,500 years ago in ancient China. And now this self-discovery technique, yeah, has evolved to many parts of the world, and it has been practiced by many empowerment and self-development coaches and practitioners. Okay, so technique Loshu ni, Loshu astrology ni, sebenarnya dia sudah lama, dia sudah macam diketahui lama sangat, ancient orang cakap kuno kan, dia sudah di improvise, dia sudah kena upgrade, dia yalah ancient means lebih kurang 4,500 tahun dahulu di China dulu dia orang sudah guna dia punya teknik, dia sudah improvise, dan teknik ini actually sudah digunakan di merata dunia sudah, especially mereka yang ada passions, orang cakap kerja mereka sebagai empowerment yang bagi coaching sama orang, dia orang practice, okay, so memang sudah ada. So mungkin kita saja yang lambat kan, tidak tahu tentang teknik yang ini. Okay, so yeah, I myself is a practitioner and a teacher to those who want to be a practitioner in Loshu self-discovery technique. So I often use this technique as a tool to support my children, my siblings, my family. And somehow I also check my friends, you know. And through these processes, I have a lot of aha moments, you know, and I understand everyone better, understand them better, and I am able to actually work around them to support them in more effective ways. Aha, isn't it? So yeah, saya adalah practitioners Loshu teknik ini. Saya juga orang cakap pengajar. Saya mengajar juga tentang teknik ini untuk sesiapa yang berminat belajar tentang teknik ini. Okay, so saya guna teknik ini untuk mengenali anak-anak saya. Saya punya adik-beradik, saya punya whole family lah, keluarga saya. So that bila saya, yalah dengan cara ini kan, saya pun notice lah, banyak juga aha moment saya lah, kenapa begini, kenapa begitu kan. Jadi saya pun faham diorang dengan lebih mendalam, dan saya boleh orang cakap bantu diorang lah, macam ada cara untuk bantu diorang dengan lebih berkesan lagi, supaya diorang move forward in diorang punya life. Okay, takkan saya yang mau move sendiri-sendiri saja kan? Of course saya mau everyone around me, including you there, out there. Saya juga mau kamu orang move forward in your life, know yourself better kan? So yeah, oftentimes right, the clients who receive their reports about themselves, analyze using this technique, ancient moment kan, diorang pun ada aha moment diorang. They also have aha moments. Like, wow, yes, aha, interesting, right? Interesting to know yourself, really. So, this tool kan, dia provides accuracy. It provides accuracy to the abilities and the shortcomings of a person about 90 to 95%. You may not believe this, but for the benefits of doubts, you should definitely try or do it at least once in your lifetime. Why? Because you only just need once. That's all you need. That's all you need. Okay. So again, saya nak bagi tahu. Banyak klien yang guna ni kan teknik ni, dia orang pun rasa macam wow, tepat banyak dia punya yang ditulis di situ tentang dia orang cakap wow tepat. So basically dia ada numbers lah, ketepatan tu ada up to accurate dia kan up to 90 to 95% menggunakan teknik ini saja, mengetahui apa kelebihan, apa kelemahan diri diorang, okay? Diri kita, diri diorang lah, okay? So mungkin kau tidak percaya yang dia boleh bagi tahu kau punya kelebihan, kekurangan dalam diri kau about that very high percentage, 90 to 95%. Mungkin kau tak percaya. So daripada kau rasa macam tidak percaya saja begitu kan, baik kau buat. Baik kau try, baik kau cuba. Baik kau cuba sekali. Cubalah sekali dalam seumur hidup kamu. Satu kali saja. Kenapa satu kali saja? Cukuplah. Satu kali saja pun kau memang tahu sudah kau punya perangai. Bah. Tidak ada yang jahat. Bah. Kelemahan saja tu boleh diperbaiki. Okay? So, okay. Now, you can find the link for this self-discovery. The pack, you know, it is offered under AEI Wellness website. Yeah, you can check out the link. I think my friend will put it in the Facebook. Ada link dia. Okay, kamu orang boleh klik link itu. Dan yeah, go from there. Alright. So kamu boleh indicate juga if you want it dalam English atau bahasa boleh juga. Okay. So help my team will put the link down in this comment so that you can click. That is the package or the pack offered by AEI Wellness. Okay, so yeah, if you like personalized lah, macam you just interested, you like me to do the readings, you know, for you, you can feel free to contact me, you know. stressabundance@gmail.com, Okay, senang saja. You see that I am Trace Abundance. Okay, so traceabundance@gmail.com. You can email me ataupun you can go to my social media, my IG or my Facebook. Look for me, Trace Abundance. And then you can DM me from there. So in my IG, I have a link there that you can click. Okay, you can click there and then you follow that link. You can find out the transformations. So that one is using this technique to analyze who you are. Okay. So if you feel comfortable, Lakan, to have Loshu coach or practitioner from Singapore or European countries like in the US and Mexico, then you feel free to contact AEI Wellness for more information. We have practitioners, we have teachers from all over the world now. Okay, so you can just contact them, AEI Wellness, and then ask them to get Lotus Loshu punya teacher coach to help you with your self discovery using this technique. Okay, this technique kan, AEI Wellness also offer dia as a course ya. The method for the self discovery. If you are interested to use it for yourself or you practice as a coach for others, you can sign up for this course. Okay, you kindly contact AEI Wellness. Okay, at hello AEI Wellness, aliasaiwellness.com, or you fill in the I'm interested form in the comments below. I think they will put in the link in the comments. So if you're interested to belajar this, to learn this course, you go and click that link. All right, it is very, very easy to use and a very practical technique for self-discovery. Yeah, it can be learned and it can be used for yourself or parents, HR in the company, teachers, and everyone. So they have really great course, the flow of the course, and you practice a lot, and you will be, when you come out, then you feel very confident to be able to use it actually. So yeah, if you are interested, please click the link. Okay, so after you go through this course, then actually you get two benefits. If you join this course, you can provide Loshu readings to individuals for self-discovery, and you can earn some extra income for yourself at the same time. And you can help your clients to grow. It's really a great feeling to see someone grow, you know. So very noble feelings, okay. And number two, you have your benefits. If you follow this course, you can be part of AEI Wellness panel, Loshu practitioners, and be paid for Loshu reading services rendered to AEI Wellness. What it means is that kamu dapat peluang jadi reader, klien-klien dari seluruh dunia, diorang nak tahu tentang diri diorang, kamu akan partner dengan AEI Wellness, menjadi salah satu diorang punya panel untuk melihat reading, you know, reading untuk orang lain. Okay, so basically it earns you money, give you pocket lah, deep pocket orang cakap kan. So, interested yet? Are you interested yet? You have to consider it today. Okay. Kita pun sudah almost end of this live. And I really want to thank you for being with us. And I hope that you have the benefits of the info that you have learned today. Okay. So, thank you so much. And before I end, I actually want to bring you back again. Who is AEI Wellness? What are they doing? Okay, I'm going to bring you back. I'm going to tell you all about them. So AEI Wellness actually is they advocate and promote wellness practices for the soul, for the mind, okay, for your emotions, for your body, for your aura, for the air and water, for the food, for the land, the people, your home, your workplace, environment, and the whole world or beyond. Very, very interesting, very, very different. Yeah, so they are very holistic. So if you want to inquire more related to AEI Wellness punya products or courses or coaching or and consultations, you can find them in the website. Yeah, email to them hello@aeiwellness.com or find them in Facebook AEI Wellness, or you can find AEI Wellness brand partners, okay, business partners. In Malaysia, in Brunei, Singapore, Europe, and in the US. Find out more. If you are not sure, just contact them. Okay. So, itu saja actually. That's all. You tune into AEI Wellness Facebook and okay for the live sharing and other channels that we will announce later for the live sharings on the 25th of this February. Okay, Friday at the same time, and we will talk about something more interesting. Reincarnations. Is it real? And win more prizes. Win more prizes by joining. Okay, so that's all. Akhir kata, end of my words. I know self-discovery might sound like a very big and intimidating concept, but it's really just a process of examining your life, figuring out what's missing, and then you take the steps forward towards complete self-enlightenment and also ultimately self-fulfillment. Okay, so itu saja dari saya. Thank you so much and see you again next round by me. And next month, okay? Stay tuned. Bye, everyone.